Oh, Jim, don't worry. He's just a fat kid. Just a fatty.
He's smuggling watermelons.
Yeah, this kid's trying to steal watermelons.
That's like civil liberties violation.
I was like, what the fuck is he doing? They can see it from there.
Two other guys came with like a woman in a wheelchair. She was pregnant. She gave birth right there, and then they picked up the baby and they put it in the spots.
You can't pee in these bottles. It's like, what are you supposed to do?
Yeah.
That sounds like a violation of human rights.
Yeah.
Screw the fatty with the watermelons.
Yeah. So that you can sell them before the seeds actually develop from the little white ones. They don't taste as good because they haven't actually matured and gotten all of those nutrients and the flavor and the sweetness in there. But they're pink, but it's not as good juice. The fruit.
Hey guys, Blonde Way back. I'm Aaron.
I'm Calvin.
And we are here with a movie that neither of us have seen.
Nope.
Neither of us have seen? I think it works either way. I've heard it both ways.
Neither.
That's wrong.
Well, that's how you pronounced it when a horse does it.
The Departed is the movie we're going to be watching today, voted by you guys over at patreon.com and or blindwave.com.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it all goes to blindwave.com.
It goes to blindwave.
If you just go there, it's faster. But
yeah.
Anyway, thank you. And also make sure that you make recommendations because we also have been using that to help us decide on what to put on polls. So don't forget, it's you don't have to, you just have to make an account. It's a free account.
It's a free account.
Blindwave.com. Make recommendations for movies or TV shows. And then we can help make more polls and find new shows to watch.
Live updated.
Now, similar to, I don't know how many Scorsese movies we've watched. I haven't seen it.
See, Wolf of Wall Street.
And Goodfellas.
Goodfellas. Django.
Jenga, that's Tarantino. You ain't gonna trick me. But I haven't seen a lot of the Scorsese movies, and this is another one of them. So I know of a couple actors.
Five or six, maybe.
And I know one quote that people say all the time. I don't know if they say it all the time, but I've heard it a lot.
Eric says it all the time.
I don't think I have anything. I know the runtime is like 2.5 hours.
Yeah, it's a Scorsese.
Yeah, so. With that, we can only put so much here on YouTube, so make sure that you check out the full-length reaction. It's our entire reaction, uncut, unedited, but there is no reference footage. You'll have to find that yourself.
We're watching it off Amazon.
Let's see what this movie's all about.
Buzzer!
It's a broken.
Do,
should we have downloaded
do,
it?
Do.
Editor, sorry. We're just going to do a download thingy.
I'm taking that.
Well, it shouldn't take that long.
I don't want to be a product of my environment. I want my environment to be a product of me.
The riots. I was like Mike Ehrmantraut mixed with
years
Stanley.
Ago we had the chair.
Or Nicholson.
This is one of my favorite Rockman songs.
Yeah. Protection.
Protection money.
Don't make me have to come down here again for this. Won't happen again, Mr. C.
Mr. C.
Is that
Jack Nicholson?
Yeah.
Looks like it.
It does. Yeah, that's it.
You come by L Street.
Oh no. It's not Nicholson. It's the dad from Rundown.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it is? That's who it is.
You
I don't like seats.
Man makes his own way. No one gives it to you. You have to take it. Non serviam.
He's constantly in shadow.
Man, I can't fucking tell.
My dad.
Oh! Jeez. What all does he run? Does Scorsese always just do like...
Crime,
mobster guys?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go.
What's the difference? It's my boy.
Oh, is that who that was? Little Matt Damon?
Huh.
Was it Sullivan?
Yeah.
Pencils.
Oh.
Okay.
I get a blowjob again. That's great. Your mother must be a wonderful woman. Fuck yourself.
This way, your black guy in Boston. Each and every one of you will serve with distinction, honor, and integrity.
Why do I feel like that's not the case?
Uh-oh.
Sullivan, sign the plain clothes right out of the gate. Congratulations. We're going to go out for beer. You want
to
come?
No, oh, undercover.
Plain clothes right away, huh?
Yeah.
Has this been like a long job. Like, you're getting to school, you put some in here.
Probably.
Alright. This is not the regular police! This is the state police!
Fire!
Your training will illustrate
state police, huh?
Hey, mm-hmm. Mr. President.
Yeah.
We won't be working together. That is the record. You'll be working with Captain Ellen.
Oh, Wahlberg?
Yeah.
Oh, dang.
He's young.
Yeah, I know.
You're a worker. You rise fast.
That's why I'm going stick. Thank you, sir.
How did you say thank you to?
Yeah.
You're going to rise fast. Is his shoes backwards?
Dude,
Leo's so young, too.
Yeah.
What year was this movie? Do you know?
I don't know. Probably late 80s, early 90s?
Sure.
I would guess.
So, you got family connections down in Southie, right? Through your father? Why don't you tell us about your Uncle Jackie?
Uncle Jackie?
He got popped by the cash from 95 and found his body out by the airport.
That's right. I remember his funeral.
Good. Close casket.
That's right.
Jeez.
I got a question. How fucked up are you?
Huh. He looks like he's shortly out of Titanic.
What you got, Stassi?
Yeah.
Among many, many, many other departures from our normative behavior.
What's this got to do with
it? Are they trying to make sure he's not, like, dirty?
Why are you pretending to be a cop? This
hey.
Is an elite unit.
Damn, there's all kinds of people in this.
Yeah.
Smash or...
So tell me, what's a lace curtain motherfucker like you doing in the States?
Families are always rising or falling in America, am I right?
Who said that?
Hawthorne.
Do you want to be a cop? Or do you want to appear to be a cop? It's an honest question.
I don't have any family.
Oh.
When my mother dies, we don't have any more connection.
So he's trying to get away from the crime of his family?
Is it the crime, or is it just, like, really high class and he hates them?
I don't know. They talk about a lot of them being criminals, though, too. They might have money from being criminals. I don't know. Departed. This is a thing. Oh, from Costello.
Mm-hmm. Frank?
Huh.
We can't conceal that you were a trainee. You'll be convicted of a crime. We're thinking a guilty plea to assault and battery would make sense.
Given your nature?
You'll do enough jail time to convince anyone this is no setup. You'd be on probation, see a court order.
Who's going
to
be, like, deep undercover?
So they are going to make him a cop, just not a cop.
Yeah.
Like a deep undercover, go to prison for a year so you can look like you're not a cop. I heard this one before.
Yeah.
Or at least the music.
It's a beer commercial song.
You're right. Oxygen,
smoking. With oxygen. Oh, gosh.
Cranberry juice.
Is that one of the three guys of Costello's?
Yes, you're
very ready.
Where do you get your period?
Jeez!
Well, I'm the guy that tells you there are guys you can hit, and there's guys you can't. Now, that's not quite a guy you can't hit, but it's almost a guy you can't hit.
It's not quite a guy you can't hit, but he's almost a guy you can't hit.
Excellent, fine. Why are you drinking?
You gonna say cranberry juice?
Yep.
A cranberry juice.
What is it, your period?
You gotta hit him.
Hey, fuckhead. It's Jackie's nephew. What? Oh, fucking what?
Oh! I guess he is a guy you can hit.
Not a guy he can hit.
Oh, yeah.
It's almost the guy he can't hit.
So
Somebody, you may already know, stole 20 microprocessors from the mass processor company out on Route 128. These are the kind of processors that...
Where else would you get? Where else would you get processors from? Mass processor.
You do not want to miss it if Costello takes a dump.
We'd miss a lot less if you made your informants available to us for closer dinner.
Without asking.
Feed them shit and keep them in the dock. The girl's on a good day.
That's...
Normally he's a very nice guy. Don't judge him from this meeting alone.
Normally he's a very nice guy.
Everybody has to temper their expectations of him.
If he was killed, he probably did something wrong.
Well, not the robbery. That's not wrong. He did something else wrong?
Wave to your girlfriend, honey.
I mean, fuck yourself.
Who was it?
Get
that? Wave to your girlfriend who?
Welcome to the neighborhood.
Wait, were one of those guys following him?
Maybe both.
Maybe neither.
Are you a state?
I'm actually going to law school.
That guy's like, I just woke up here with my donuts and my coffee.
Oh, yeah,
I think he's a delivery guy.
Yeah, it is.
Maybe you can shoot someone and then you have to see me professionally.
I'll stab someone in the eye with a fucking ice pick if it gets me dinner with you.
Wait. I'll stab someone in the heart with an ice pick.
Beeper.
No.
Cell phone.
Folding phone. Late 90s then? So both of them, one is like a surveillance listening van, the other one's just driving it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Oh. Are these guys he can hit?
I think these are probably guys that he can hit.
Broke his hand. Is he... I thought he was gonna kill him with that somehow.
I thought he was gonna stick
like
that hook
in his
fucking
eye
throat
or something.
Man.
Now you also do probation work?
Jeez.
I guess they were trying to cut in on the territory and he put a stop to it.
What Freud said about the Irish is we're the only people who are impervious to psychoanalysis.
Hmm. Yeah.
Why do you do it then?
Some people do get better.
I'm not sure if he's being honest or not, you know?
No, I think he's just being a massive flirt.
The difference between their lives, too. Like,
they're very
similar. He's like a corrupt cop then, and he's like a real super undercover cop, I guess. And
they're both working both sides.
And his life is like, he's getting like his great penthouse and stuff.
Yeah.
Do you know who I am? You met my friend, Mr. French, the other night.
Oh, that's who that was, okay.
His real name, Mr. French?
It's either good or bad.
I'm not the cops. Not asking you.
He's either gonna shoot you in the alley.
Just do not stop having a mafia in Providence. And this can cause me a lot of problems. I knew your father.
People keep saying that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's dead.
Show me your house.
Oh, make sure there's nothing like inside his cast.
Yeah.
Oh, good place to hide it, I guess, huh?
No! That particular apartment, anyway.
No! Are you still a cop?
No! No!
Swear on your mother's grave. You're still not a cop.
I am not a fucking cop.
Are you gonna stop doing coke deals with your jerk off?
Damn. That hurt so bad, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it would.
Imagine I just started using a boot and hitting your ankle.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
After breaking the cast off of it.
Yeah.
That shines in her hand. I love the dear fingers that I want.
Who was that? Wait, was that one of the guys in the... Those are the guys trying to shake up the place, right?
Mockery.
Maybe. I don't know who
I
they
think
are.
They were the guys that, the yeah, they the sent. Tell
me that these two gentlemen came from Providence. I saw a dead guy. I think I'm having post-traumatic stress. Can I meet you for lunch? I see that.
I didn't know where that was going at first.
I know. I thought he was calling Costello or whatever.
I saw a dead guy.
Good. In this car, you'll find the gun that didn't register official. Providence.
In the trunk of the glove compartment.
So that's the guy who was a uniform before, right?
Yeah.
So he's just like, now that's like his new partner, and it just some chump he can just kind of like lead.
Yeah.
If you indulge me.
Is that a hand?
Yeah.
The point I'm making with John Lennon is a man could look at anything and make something out of it. For instance, I look at you, and I think, what can I use you for?
Put it downstairs here. Yeah, thank you.
Maybe we could work something out.
Good.
And send this to his wife.
I thought it was nice the way you asked the guy which hand he jerked off with. I hope this don't shake later up.
So I remember she ain't that sentimental.
Microprocessors, chips, computer parts. Anybody says anything about anything like that, you let us know.
Queen gives a shit. It's got a freaking bow on it.
I think you are a cop, my son.
Okay.
What's that about?
I thought he was going to do cocaine.
Yeah. Maybe it cools down your nose for the coke.
If your father were alive and saw you here sitting with me, let's say you have a word with me about this. In fact, he'd kill seven guys just to cut my throat, and he could do it. There may be something you don't know about William Costigan Sr.
Is he trying to talk him out of this?
I don't know. Maybe just like an old guy warning a young guy that, you know, maybe this isn't the life for you. There's better options.
Give it to me. He doesn't know what a fucking lawyer looks like. Whose briefcase is this? All right. It's off.
Good.
Afternoon, Mr. Fitzgibbons.
You my turn?
What do you think?
Mom, I'm not going to make it home for supper.
Sorry, yeah, I got held up.
Everybody out. Move.
Whoa! Damn, that took off quick. Like, there's gasoline already on the floor.
Yeah.
Run the last number he called. That's his house. Now, whatever the address is, I'll swear to the judge I surveilled him there and never fucking get out. We got a warrant.
So he made progress and warned him?
That's nice of you.
Yeah.
I guess at the same time. Do you know what? Psychiatrist or psychologist, whatever, for police officers might be a good, like, connection as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, sure.
If files or anything.
Well, yeah, medical records or private right. Sessions. And
especially if she, like, stays here with him, leaves files here or
yeah.
something.
Yeah. Or, like...
Oh, shit.
It's actually quite common.
I
gotta go to
work. Jeez!
So you had a parent who was a drunk.
Let's keep it with you. Talk about how you feel.
How I feel. How I feel.
Is he feeding a baby? Oh!
Probably.
Okay, it wasn't feeding a baby. What'd he put in the bottle?
He sit there.
Keep residue off his hands?
That's one thing I figured out about myself in prison. My hand does not shake. Ever.
This is my shooting hand.
Mm-hmm.
Why is he here?
Do you see cops?
That's part of what I do. I mean, I normally don't see cadets who've been kicked out of the academy.
Why?
Part of like a sentence or something, maybe?
You get a better job, huh?
I looked at your file.
Don't get...
That's a lot of oxy.
You have a record of assault.
Yeah.
Fucking day. It's been a year of this. I've had enough of this shit.
Calm down.
A year?
A year undercover is a long fucking time.
Okay? Exactly. You're nobody. You signed the papers, remember? Now, we're the only two people on the face of this earth who can know you're a cop.
Oh, man.
Let me just erase your file. Huh? How about that? How about we erase your file and then bang? You're just another soldier for Costello. But...
They're making a monster here.
Yeah, I know.
What are you waiting for, honestly? I mean, do you want him to chop me up and feed me to the poor? Is that what you guys want?
We are building a case. It takes time. We know that.
I think Costello's got a spy inside the Special Investigation Unit.
You serious? I'm afraid so.
This is the worst place for you to be here right now.
I know you have to come here, but now that you're here...
Yeah, court ordered or something.
What do you want?
Yeah.
You want the truth?
You can't handle the truth.
Value.
Oh.
I mean, if you're in distress, I will help you.
Script.
It's my card and a prescription for 20 lorazepam. I'm transferring you to another counselor.
Good. So you want to get a cup of coffee?
Not a patient anymore.
Because they're transferring, as you're saying?
Yeah, I guess.
It's going to make whatever they have going on complicated, right?
Do you guys know anything about this? Staff Sergeant Sullivan's team will ID the bad guys. Anybody?
Is this a...
No.
It's a double sting? A surprise operation that only the top brass know about in order to surprise anybody on the inside?
Sure, yeah, I guess. He didn't even have a sponge. I got hopped on the phone real quick.
Hi, Dad.
Yes.
Something big came up at work. I'm not gonna be home for supper.
We'll just have to sit down without you and your friends.
Oh no, my friends are still coming. So we'll just see you for lunch instead tomorrow.
Your mother will be proud.
All right.
Dude, his face when he walked over.
Mm-hmm.
They're ready.
So is it really a deal?
I don't think there is.
Okay, come operate the cameras. You might need the guys to log.
All cell phone signals are under surveillance to the courtesy of my federal friends over there.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, he just got...
So did he already get caught then? Or is it like now it's active? All information in and out.
He doesn't know if they caught it or not. They... Oof.
I used to be able to do this shit on like the flip phones. Just feel that 5 button in the middle. Yeah, he's watching everyone, isn't he?
Yep.
There's Costello, there's the French, there's Fitzy, Delahunt.
Dude, that looks so terrible. How can you tell it's anybody?
All right, turn off your cell phones. Fitzy's got the chicken. Check your weapons.
Gotcha, okay. So maybe they're not listening to the cops. They're just listening to their phones. Damn, I wish they were tracking the police phones. They already think there's a leak.
If they were smart, they would have.
They turned off their cell phones. Search randomly for calls made from the area.
807 phones are live in this area.
The narrow the area.
There's still one phone up.
Where?
Hmm, money.
The buyers are there.
Man, this is... They're watching them, he's watching for them. Everyone's trying to figure out who the...
Don't do my guy.
Who the fuck are you? I'm the guy who does his job. You must be the other guy.
I love that line. There's like a little keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
Those are microchips? Like microprocessors?
Yeah, they're huge.
I guess it's...
They're integrated circuits. I mean, it's as small as they could make them back then.
Please tell me those cars aren't empty. I mean, Jesus fucking Christ.
Please tell me that those Chinaman's cars aren't empty.
Ah, escaping on boat.
I didn't figure we had a Navy.
Oh, jeez.
Oh,
the lead of the task force didn't seem too broken up, that the op got botched.
Mm-hmm.
They knew everything, all right? There was a leak from the inside.
Yeah, in that room. So you know there's a rat there, and they know there's a rat in that deal.
Good morning.
Good morning. Want a French donut?
Yeah.
This movie.
Croissant.
Yeah.
This movie's like playing Guess Who. Like, they're just, like, knocking down people trying to figure out, like, this one?
What?
Hello?
What the fuck is it with you and your phone?
Huh?
Something for work.
Hey,
yeah.
Do you like Little Miss Thing sucking on your cock?
Yes, I do.
So earn it. We got a cop in my crew.
Yeah, I know. I'm kind of getting that feeling, too.
It's one of yours.
Frank, you gotta figure it's the newest guy, right?
Don't relax. I can't relax.
I mean, maybe. I don't know.
I love a shot of this.
Yeah, it's
like,
cool.
Through the glass and stuff.
How are you, Francis?
Oh.
Where did my mother call me, Francis?
I know she did.
You're lying to me.
Not exactly.
What did you do with the real microprocessors, Frank? Microprocessors.
Oh, who's this gonna be?
Excuse me. Had a date with some angels.
I don't know. Jack Nicholson's just—he's one actor that I can connect sunglasses to more frequently. I don't know why.
Yeah.
Dude, no, he's not doing. What the hell?
Took off an armored car at the Denham Mall. What the fuck you do? You paganese in Providence?
Fucking now I do.
What the fuck do you do?
What? I gotta pay Costello and wait for him to trade me to the FBI? Because that's what he does.
FBI? What the fuck you talking about, FBI? What the fuck did you say about the FBI, huh?
Never say what you thought I said.
Now, what the fuck did you just fucking say?
Why do you think he never gets busted? Costello's a protected FBI informant. He'll trade you out.
What?
I thought I was supposed to go into shock. I'm not in shock. It fucking hurts.
Oh my gosh, dude.
He's a protected FBI informant?
Yeah. That fucking throws their whole investigation.
The FBI. He is giving information to the FBI. He's a protected fucking informant. I mean, aren't they always trying to make it a federal case and it never gets made?
Go around the back, I'll open the door. Go on.
I'd say, like, what have you got a scene? This is dangerous.
Yeah, come on, man. You have some supper. We'll talk in the kitchen.
He seems so much nicer than Wahlberg.
He is so much nicer than what? What do you mean?
It's the good bad cop thing, isn't it? Who's she?
Want some coke?
What? Did he swap them or something, or?
Maybe, I don't know.
No, he just held both of their envelopes, so I don't know. Oh, she's moving.
This is inappropriate.
No, it's not inappropriate. You're not a patient.
As long as Matt Damon doesn't show up at the door.
Sure. Hey, I'm here to help you pack.
We are all convinced that Costello has at least one mole inside the Special Investigations Unit. You will investigate everybody and anybody.
It's not exactly a dream job for us.
Ladies see the ring, they know immediately you must have some cash or your car must work.
It's working. Overtime.
D-M-I.
Yeah, well, yeah, you didn't need to say that part. What? What kind of theater is this? Never been to one of these.
Adult theater.
I don't understand that either. At least now you're on a street. It'd be a little bit easier to blend in.
Sure.
Almost. Does he know he's being followed, or are you just gonna lose him? Oh, don't get seen by him. Make a rest. Why don't you have your phone vibrate?
Hopefully it's not him.
What, is it going to be some random guy? Just get probably stabbed? He just stabbed some guy getting groceries. Oh, shit.
There you go.
Don't look at it.
Too late now. Light speed. That's why you don't look above, like, the eye line. That's where cameras are.
Oh, wait, he got access to the guy chasing him.
Did he?
Enhance! Dang, do they know?
Jesus Christ. I'm sure by now you know. I got an informer in my outfit. You accused me once. I put up with it. You accused me twice. I quit. You pressured me to fear for my life, and I will put a fucking bullet in your head as if you were anybody else. Okay?
They drop a gun. Yeah.
You got something you wanna ask me? I got this red. This annoying key. Brings up questions. You see, like, you're the new guy.
Yeah, new guy. See? I said.
Yeah. Yeah.
I probably could be you. Yeah. Yeah, I know that much. But I don't want to be you, Frank. Heavy lies the crown. Sort of thing.
I'll see you Christmas.
See you at Christmas? Is it almost Christmas time, or?
Must be. I don't know.
There's a boat coming up Gloucester. Frank should give you all the details.
Don't say anything about this boat. It could be a trap. What was that about?
Excuse me.
Part of that scene seemed weird.
I think it's also just Jack Nicholson.
Maybe.
Problem?
He's breathing the role.
So you got any advice for me? Just, I mean, generally.
I like how we flipped to, like, a similar scene from the other side.
Yeah.
Source. He's here beside you. Follow Costello, you'll find his rat.
Are they watching him? Is that what that was?
I don't know.
I want you to know you don't gotta stay.
You think about leaving?
If we're not gonna make it, it's gotta be you that gets out.
Okay. He's just saying the relationship in general. What work would you do to try to find the research of the cop that you're the rat of. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
What research do you do to kind of make it look like you're working to find someone?
Huh? Of course I know how to spot a cop.
How's that?
But he's not paying attention to us. He's a cop.
What does he?
A cop.
Hey, how you doing? What kind of dog is that?
Cop.
Cop.
She ain't know the soul. She must be a cop.
She's probably the fucking police commissioner.
Huh.
You can get out of here.
Using a new crew tonight, new guys.
I thought I was on for this.
I changed my mind. Jimmy out the back. Bring him up.
Bring him up.
You're a cop.
What?
You're an artist, you're a cop. We're guessing who cops are. You know most good-looking women are cops?
Most good-looking women are cops.
Yeah. He's the only name that's going to come up, huh?
He's moving something with all new guys, a whole new crew. No, no, I can't tell you.
You're far enough away.
It's probably disinformation. Just keep following him, all right? Listen, I need to see you today. No, 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 today.
You heard nothing about drugs.
Good, he's playing smart. I can't tell you anything. It could be misinformation. Yes.
No way, he says.
My golfer just walked by and flipping him up.
I want constant surveillance on Captain Quinnan starting right now. Good.
Then. He's gonna peg him as the rat?
That would make sense.
Hoping that we follow him and it leads to the rat.
I would hope that the captain is
careful,
aware enough. Like, he's experienced.
Sure.
He's not stupid.
Man, he said we gotta meet today. Today, dang it.
Mm-hmm.
So he's gonna meet and talk with him. He's gonna think that he's ratting for Costello. They're gonna blame him as a rat. They're gonna find out who the real rat is. I like the street sign. Here's the address.
It's also real easy to tell that nobody should be here but you and whoever's following you. Is he going to go to the next roof?
I don't know.
I think we got him. I think Quinnan's meeting with him right now.
All right, listen to me.
Oh, shit, man.
Yeah. Where the fuck are you? We're trying to reach you. We found the rat.
Listen, we're going to take him out. Now look it.
The address is 314 Washington Street. You got it? All right, we'll see you there. Why?
You were followed.
By who?
By Costello's people.
Impossible.
I wonder if Costello's got on the inside, too. Come on, come on.
You're both fucked now.
What the fuck is
going on? Oh, shit, man.
Fuck, that shit looks like Queen is meeting with all of them.
Yeah. He must be our guy.
You gotta get out of here. Take the fire escape. Fuck you. I'll be fine.
Shit, man. They're gonna shoot him.
Go.
Yeah. Him and the asshole are the only two people that knows he's undercover.
Mm-hmm.
They joked about that earlier. It's gonna be...
Oh no. No!
Fuck.
Oh my gosh!
Sad, something just came off the building. What do you mean something came off the building? Go again with that.
Sad,
something came off the fucking roof.
Sorry, there's a fucking body.
Come on, mind to go.
Check out, we gotta get on foot if we want to get up on this thing.
Where the fuck were you?
What the fuck happened?
You're fucking late! Get in the back!
What do you mean something came off the roof?
What the fuck's going on? I what came to meet you.
What
get in the back! Get in the back!
No pursuit.
No pursuit. Oh, there you go. I thought they ran him over.
I think they did.
Oh my gosh. Did he just turn off?
Yeah.
I told internal investigations to follow Captain Quinnan.
Why?
That's internal investigations business.
Fucking piece of shit! Hey, fucking bitch! Let him go!
I can fucking investigate anybody I fucking want to.
No, come on,
I don't give a fuck what you think.
Fuck with the tech guys to unlock those files. They're gonna take a leave of absence.
Take a leave of what?
Oh, fuck.
Queenan is dead.
Fuck.
I'm your boss now.
I made a mistake. I gave you the wrong address, but you showed up at the right one, didn't you?
Tell me why I didn't tell nobody, huh?
You see undercover too?
Maybe.
You killed the guy who had all the information. Now Dignam's gone. Forget about him. He resigned.
Don't give a fuck about Dignam.
He's gone too?
He left. I don't know where he is.
Damn, now he doesn't have anybody.
Yeah.
Is there information on the phone? Oh, man. Redial? Oh, man.
If he's smart, he won't pick up.
He knows he's dead.
That's the phone that shouldn't ring.
Yeah, who would be getting you?
Do not pick it up.
Oh,
fuck.
I really don't want him to get caught. Neither one says anything.
Mm-hmm. Which phone rings next? Makes a difference.
Oh, what you doing? What you doing?
Yeah. I called this number on a dead guy's phone. Who are you? So it is you. Thank God you're all right. We were very worried. Who are you? This is Sergeant Sullivan. I'm taking over Queen's unit.
He's
trying to talk to Dignam and confirm it.
Staff Sergeant Dignam.
He's on a leave of absence. He's very upset. We're all very upset.
Nope. I wouldn't
do it. Yeah, hang up right now.
I mean, I have maybe more information than you, but still.
It's easy to come in. Can you come in?
No. No. Nope. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
Don't touch that with a 39 and a half foot pole.
The two people who know are either dead or suspended. No, I wouldn't. Mm-mm.
No.
Police have confirmed that the body of the man found dead in the Fenway marshes yesterday afternoon is that of Timothy Delahunt, an undercover policeman for the city of Boston.
He was.
This was the scene yesterday.
And there's the rat.
Yeah.
What can't you believe? I spent all fucking night dragging the poor bastard in there. Tell me how they find him so fast. I'm embarrassed.
That's what he can't believe?
I still don't believe he was a cop. I don't believe it. The cops are saying he's a cop. So I won't look for the cop.
Oh.
You saw fits.
Maybe. But also the line he had makes me think that he was too.
Yeah.
In the mind.
Not where some guy from John Hancock goes every Thursday to get a fucking blowjob! Don't laugh!
They have two songs in this movie. Two!
Yeah.
This song and Gimme Shelter.
Yeah, you gotta tell. The two cops, not very subtle. They're not gonna be very subtle from now on, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
So get rid of them.
There's no need for you to go yourself, Frank.
Get rid of the fucking tail!
Hmm.
Alright, it's the warehouse he owns over on Sheffield. He's gotta have a container or a truck or something there. Go, 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 go.
So he's still messaging people? Who's he messaging? He just thinks that maybe that guy will help him?
I guess.
Huh. Huh. So he brought him here? Jeez.
Okay, so
Oh, damn.
I guess he just wants out.
Maybe. Yeah, maybe he's done.
I mean, he's got a wife. Right?
Marriage, at least, I guess, yeah. I don't know how long it's been, either. Oh, my gosh! Well, that went to hell. Oh, he got shot too, huh?
I'd rather do that than burn to death. But, yeah, that fucking sucks.
Is that Bills or Collins?
It's Collins.
How the fuck did this happen?
You're an FBI informant? Are you fucking kidding me? Grow up.
Of course I talk to the FBI.
Do they know who I am?
I never gave up anybody. You're like a...
The son? To you? Is that what this is about? All that murdering and fucking and no sons.
Jeez.
Rat prick!
Jeez. He killed him because he was a rat.
I guess.
Now what's going on?
Who's this?
Gwen, we lost Frank.
I don't know where the other cops are.
They didn't run to those shots.
I got Costello here.
Yeah, great job.
Dude, neither of them got caught?
Thank you.
He's been waiting here a long time for you. How'd you get with Dr. Foss? Caller ID.
Oh, what's gonna happen here?
Good to see you, Trooper.
Yeah. Colin Sullivan, we spoke on the phone.
Yeah.
So, now how long were you undercover?
Long time. Long time.
Yeah.
Now neither of them have any reason to fear each other, right?
Thanks.
Look, I just want my identity back, all right? That's all.
All right. I just see you want to be a cop again.
No. Being a cop's not an identity. I want my identity back. I'll have to excuse my behavior. My only contact in the last 6 months has been a police shrink.
Oh, no!
How's that working for you? Is it helpful?
What are you going to do about Costello's rat in this building?
I'm gonna find the prick.
Yeah.
I can't get into your file unless I have your password.
It's my name. William Costigan Jr. They gave it to me in case I had to explain myself to someone like you.
It's your name.
Give me 2 minutes. I'll have you out of here in no time.
Where's he going?
He's gonna erase the undercover shit, isn't he?
Oh, deletes right there, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the
there it
envelope.
Is.
Oh, shit.
There it fucking is. Oh,
follow
my gosh. Get the fuck in that room and stop him.
Get the other cops. Get the other guy. Like, why doesn't he just do it? Let him go? Let it go? That guy wants to leave? Figure it out later. Like, what's his plan?
Alright, everything checks out, so let's get you paid.
That's not where I left it. Now he's gonna delete it.
Why do you go here?
I know. I'm not here for that, okay? I'm not. I've got to give you something. Something I need you to keep. For me. You open this if something happens to me, or if I call you and I tell you to open it. You're the only person I can trust, all right? Please.
Oh.
You
Whatever you have to say, think about it real hard, right? If you still want to tell me, you tell me in 2 weeks, okay?
Don't open it. Don't open it. He said not to open it.
Did she write his name on it?
I think so. That's bad. At least it's at her, like, doctor's office, right?
I was dreaming. I was
dead. Is that what it was? Was maybe. That in her, like...
I thought that was in her home office.
Maybe.
Really?
Is that...
Yeah. Ultrasound?
Ultrasound, yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that the water turning off? Is that us focusing on the audio?
That's the water turning off. That was the shower curtain, I think.
You got a cop in my crew.
Yeah, I know. I'm kind of getting that.
It's one of yours. Inside. You seen anything?
I thought I was the liar.
Hey, I can explain that!
Costello recorded everything. He put all the tapes in a little box and kept them with his lawyer. That was insurance.
Imagine that, you rat fuck. Costello trusted me more than anyone.
What do you want?
I told you I want my identity back.
But where are you?
3 o'clock. Where Queenan died, you keep your cell on. Some bullshit.
Fuck you! Fuck you! I'm fucking arresting you!
It's the stupidest thing you could do.
Shut the fuck up!
Jeez. What's
weapon.
He doing here?
And step away from Sergeant Sullivan!
I called you. You specifically. Look, you know who I am. I'm not gonna shoot. I told you to meet me
help,
downstairs.
Help, help, help.
Put your weapon on the deck and step away from Sergeant Sullivan! Where's Dingham? I told you to bring Dingham!
Shoot this motherfucker, will you? But right now, I need you to drop the weapon!
I told you, I have evidence cold linking this prick.
He doesn't know that.
Did you shoot this fucking prick?
You know who I am!
Just fucking kill me.
I am killing you.
What the fuck? The fuck?
Yeah. I was waiting for the hammer to drop.
Fuck! Is he dirty too or what? He must be, right?
Did you think you were the only one he had on the inside? Costello was going to sell us to the FBI. It's you and me now, you understand?
Fuck.
We gotta take care of each other, you understand?
Damn, man. That guy was just a cop.
Yeah.
Damn. Damn!
Yeah. It's his only way out.
But his girl knows. And what's in the envelope? That makes sense why I gave her the envelope, too. That's gotta lead somewhere, right?
Mm-hmm.
Dang, man.
Mm-hmm.
He was here for so long. I really didn't think he had another rat in the police force. That makes more sense, I guess.
Yeah.
Why is she here? Crying? Is that what he's
mm-hmm.
thinking? He said only contact I've had has been a shrink.
Yeah, a cop shrink. Wonder if the baby's his.
Oh, yeah. That's a good point. I didn't think about that. Probably for the best.
Mm-hmm.
I want to know what's in that envelope.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he did it. He knew what he was going to do, right? He had an idea. Oh, shit. Oh, shit!
Okay.
Damn.
Fucking everybody died, man.
Yeah.
The rat.
The rat.
Damn. What was in that envelope? Must be information for Dingham.
I would say it's probably something that he wrote, like notes or something like that, or all the evidence that Dingham would need.
Yeah. I guess, like, he was there. She knows he died. She takes the envelope, opens it up. What's it say?
Yeah.
Here's evidence towards for Dingham, I guess.
And then I guess he pieced together what happened after the attempted arrest and, like, okay, like, this guy's fucking slippery. He's going to get away again.
Depending on what's in the envelope, he easily could be like, this is who the rat is. Here's what's going on. I'm going to go arrest him. If I end up dead, he's the rat.
Yeah.
get him. And he just swept it all up, made a nice little bow.
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't it him who was like, you know, it's closed, taken care of. Like, I was back with the one guy, right? When they pinned the murder or whatever on that guy.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I really wanted Bill to get out of that. Like, I don't know how long he was in there. We know at least a year.
Over a year. Yeah. Probably a year and, like, 2 months, maybe.
But, so the one cop that called him and told him to go meet him at the wrong address, was he giving him the wrong address because he thought that he was an undercover cop? He's like, the one who wasn't here was probably the rat, and he wasn't there. So, like, was he giving him an out as to why he wouldn't be there, or, you know what I mean?
I think he'd made an honest mistake.
But it comes down
to... But he realized after the fact, hey, I gave you the wrong address and you still showed up.
Yeah. Now, why didn't I tell anybody?
Yeah.
Because that there, like, I get what Frank was saying, right? Like, he was like, oh, they're saying he's a cop, so I stopped looking for the rat. But after having that conversation, I'm like, he was really a cop. And he was...
Yeah.
Similar to the idea that we had. And it's done in a foreshadowing kind of way, I guess, right? Like, there was Bill, but there was also Delahunt, who was an undercover with Frank. So then whenever you come back and you're like, oh, well, here's Colin, who's a rat for Frank. There was another guy who was also a rat for Frank, you know? We just didn't know.
And, my gosh, both of these organizations, their numbers are padded so much by the other side. You know?
Sure.
Like... Frank is doing his shit, and he's informing on everybody else so that he can keep doing his shit. And you have Delahunt also informing. Like...
And he was, like, one of the top three guys, right?
Yeah, he was one of the lieutenants. He was the muscle.
Yeah, Fitzy French and Delahunt.
Yeah.
And he was one of the informants.
Oh, my gosh. Like, if none of them would do their shit, and if none of them needed... other people to do their shit on the other side, would there be criminals and would there be cops? You know?
I mean, if we didn't have... Well, are you kind of referring to, like, the idea of, like, well, we put a guy undercover to go there, but in order for him to seem like he is with them and undercover,
what he has to do crimes. Yeah.
No, I mean, I think there would still be some of the other crimes. But no, I get what you mean of, like... This guy has to go as far as he can so that this guy believes...
He has to prove that he belongs there by doing the bad shit.
And like what Bill says, like, I showed, like, he was murdering people. Why don't you get him for this?
Yeah.
You know, like... But that guy recorded everything, huh?
He did.
So he was always wiretapped.
Yeah. And if you're the mob boss, as long as nobody knows that you're recording everything...
But no one's gonna search you,
everyone
right?
else would assume that this is, like, as long as the people who are suspect aren't wearing a wire, nobody else is going to be recording this. Like, a mob boss would have to be stupid to record himself, right?
Sure, yeah, because he's incriminating himself.
He's
but it's giving
creating
him
evidence
so that he can trade to the FBI to get out of situations. Though he did say that he never turned in anybody who wasn't already going down.
Yeah,
now. Whether that's true or not, I don't know. But it makes sense that, like, some guys already got caught, It's like, okay, well, I'll give you a little bit more. And then that way it looks like, well, he got caught on his own and they put him away.
Sure.
But it might, A, get him less competition maybe, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or B, get someone who wasn't good out of his group or something, or I don't know.
Any number of reasons why he could use that or how he could use it.
Yeah. Dude, Matt and Leo did really good in this.
Yeah. I know.
Like, I definitely like their performances a lot. Jack Nicholson was great, too, but...
He's always Jack Nicholson.
His rat moment when he's, like doing that stuff. And then, like...
Sniveling.
I don't know what he did.
Cheesy.
He was, like, rat. Walking from behind him. He's, like...
Yeah.
And I was, like, what the fuck is he going to do? I think he was
a little bit drunk and high. And
well, he dropped his gun, right? That was his gun he dropped?
He's, like, nobody can do what I do.
Like he looked down the barrel, didn't he?
He did.
I thought it was that Bill pulled it, like Leo's character pulled it out and had it under the table and dropped it or something. And then he was like, really like,
Oh, what's this? I wonder what this could be. Oh, yeah, I think
it makes sense that he had it too.
Because Bill always had the nickel gun.
Dude, the roof drop.
Oh, my gosh.
And like all the cops like just waited, like, what was that? What was that? Like, what do you mean?
Something came off the roof.
There must be a body. Some shit's going down. Go catch all these bad guys. You know?
Stay in the car.
Sit in the car. Don't do anything. No pursuit. Don't do anything. But no. It was an interesting movie. There's a few things. Like, I like some of the shots a lot. There's that one shot after Colin talks to Frank, and you see... her...
Madeline?
In the background, through the glass and stuff like that. I really like that shot. Like it had like the focus on both of them too. It wasn't like one was blurry or anything. I think it might have been put together.
I think it was composited.
But
there was a few shots that were composited like that through glass. That way they could use just a little bit of blur and
the reflection thing in the streets and stuff. The one I thought was weird though was like they had Wahlberg and Alec Baldwin, right? Yeah. They had both of them. And it was such a weird... It was like an extra action-y camera for them standing there and talking, but it like swooped around Mark Wahlberg, and then when it switched to him, it did the same swoop around him, and then after that, they were static whenever it was on him, and I was like...
Yeah.
It felt like a weird choice, but...
I think it was to show, like, these are the powerhouses in the room. Like, everybody else is sitting down. They don't get dynamic shots. These two guys, they're like... They're playing verbal fisticuffs, you know, they do get the dynamic shots.
Yeah.
I was worried that something would happen. I wasn't expecting another rat. Well, I was expecting a good cop to do the wrong thing.
I get what you mean, yeah. Because, like, I had the same kind of thought, too. I was like, man, what if this goes wrong? How can it go wrong? I'm like, who's left for Frank's group to get Bill? Like, who is there? And, like, yeah, you're right. Like, that one guy there was on the roof, and I get the point. It's like, I understand you say you have evidence. Right now, I don't have any of this evidence. I need you to put your gun down.
Yeah. The only thing that I have right now is you pointing a gun at a fellow officer.
Yeah. And had he put the gun down, maybe things would have been different. Maybe not. I don't know.
I mean, you know? I don't know. As soon as that elevator opened.
Yeah, but could he have shot two of them or just the one guy? I don't know. It would have been a little bit more of a fight. Because the other guy came down being like, what happened? And from the one cop's perspective, you see Bill dead. And you know what you had just seen up top, you may be like, oh, this other cop was here. He saw what happened. He did take the shot, whereas I didn't, you know? Because he was standing at the elevator. And it looked like on his face, being like, I'm not going to shoot. Oh, I hope that was the right choice, you know?
Yeah.
I was like, oh, damn. It's a hit on Colin. Like, you saw the little booties on the shoes. I was like, this guy's here for a hit. And it pulled up to Dingham. And I was like,
I was not expecting Dingham.
I don't know why. I should have, I guess. Like,
yeah.
Everyone else is dead. that like was like main people or like people I would have recognized, really, you know?
I mean, he's...
Alec Baldwin would have been the only other person, I guess.
Sure. Yeah. But again, the spotless record, I wouldn't have expected him to do something like that.
Yeah.
You know?
I kept thinking, like, why didn't Bill, like, try to turn him in there inside when he was there? Like, everyone was like, oh, he's the informant. I was talking to him. I guess, like, the envelope ownership isn't enough necessarily to be like, look, he was in, like, I found that. I found it sitting around here. I don't know what it is. I don't know. You know?
Sure.
Some excuse he might come up with. But the stuff that his wife or girlfriend or fiance or whatever had, that tape player,
mm-hmm.
like, what are you going to say here? Like, You're clearly talking to Frank. You say his name. It's your voice. It's his voice.
You're coming to an agreement. You're talking about
finding the rat.
Finding the rat in his organization, yeah. Not the informant in the... Yeah.
You know what? It probably, too, was a CD to both. That would make the most sense.
Sure.
Like, you just, like, here, take this. Don't open it unless I call you and tell you to, or I die. And it probably, like, send this to Dingham. Here's this. You give it to Dingham. He hears it. He knows for sure. He shows up. He kills me. Leaves. Versus, I'm also going to send one to him. And hopefully, I can just arrest him and take him in. But if it doesn't work out, I have a backup plan.
It is funny that Costello trusted Bill more than anybody else in his organization.
So the lawyer brought him the tapes?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's so ironic. Like, he recognized that he was, like, the smartest guy. But he wasn't overly ambitious, right?
Yeah.
So just, this guy is going to be... He's but rock he had, solid. Like, he's consistent.
I could do what you want to do.
Yeah.
I could do what you do. But I don't want to.
Maybe that's why... Yeah, maybe that's why him and Frenchie were talking earlier. Is like, who can I trust anymore? Like, who is solid? Who's trustworthy? Like, maybe he was, like, thinking to himself, like, at that moment. It was like, I'm going to have to arrange this in some way if something bad happens. That this... gets to who needs it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the tapes or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
I think the only thing that I knew about this movie before watching it, I didn't realize it was this movie, but it was the scene where Jack Nicholson and the other guy are on the beach and they kill those two people.
Oh, yeah.
It was Matt Damon talking about Jack Nicholson talking to Scorsese. Like, talking out the scene and everything. So Costello shoots her in the back. And you could cut there. But if you leave the camera rolling and he says something like,
"She felt funny." Now that's a really sinister thing to say.
Yeah.
Because it means I do this a lot and there's a way people fall.
Right.
She didn't fall that way. And I go, "Oh, that, yeah, I get it, man. I get it."
And that itself would be creepy. But then the other guy steps up with a hatchet.
Did he now, step with a hatchet?
Yeah.
Oh, man, I didn't now, realize
if
that.
If you cut there, that's okay. But if you leave the camera rolling, like he kept going and going and going and making the scene like really fucking bad. Like he just, you know, the way his mind works in like telling a story and creating like a moment with a character.
Sure.
That sets up the rest of the film and how you see that person, right?
Yeah, you get a feel. It's one of those things in movies where lots of times it's like, this is telling the story and you get here, but then the after part is the, like him covered in blood.
Yeah.
What the hell is happening? Like,
your imagination runs wild.
I get some stuff too, but sometimes you let stuff run a little bit longer mm-hmm. and stuff. It's like, this is going a little bit more than, like, yeah, like, okay, he shot the guy. This is a bad guy. Oh, it's funny that he shot this woman and she did this. Oh,
yeah.
It's kind of like the same idea of like when you have like a sex scene, it's always like there's always the romantic part, the fun part, and they cut out all the mess part.
Yeah,
there's never like a clean
it's always
time.
It's always the afterglow with cigarettes. Right?
Yeah, they're just laying there like it's like isn't there usually? I feel like my time is not as relaxing right after. So there's always like what do I do now?
Yeah, like, fucking sweaty. Yeah,
I knew Leonardo was in this.
Yeah,
and then. When talking about what to watch and stuff, like the name of Jack and Matt came up, and I, okay. So I was like, I didn't know who all was in it. Someone else was just like, there's a lot of faces. Okay. So like in the beginning when we were talking about Jack, I'm like, oh yeah, I mean he might be in this at some point. I don't know where. I don't know how big he is. I don't know if he's an important part, a little part.
Yeah.
And then you said the one, I'm like, oh okay, yeah, it could be. And they showed him in shadow for so long too.
It fucked with me so long. Like in the middle of that scene, even afterwards, I was convinced that they switched out actors.
Really?
So that you couldn't exactly tell who it was at first. Because it really sounded like the dad from...
The one...
Rundown.
Yeah, I know what you mean. It's just, like, keep him in the dark for so long. And I think it adds a little bit of, like, maybe suspense on who he is. But it's like, here's, like, this dark shadow of a man. And, like, he's doing these things. He's talking to this girl, being like, you got your period yet. Like, everything they showed in those first, like, I don't know, 4 minutes or whatever it was in the very beginning.
is like really creepy and dark. It's like, this is a bad man.
This just seems like a bad guy, a creepy man, a killer man.
Then he steps into the light and you see him like, you know, taking care of this kid, asking about his family. It's like, okay, maybe he's not so bad. Maybe my first impression was wrong. And then you see him later, it's like, nope, he's bad. My first impression was correct. Sure. I should have believed it.
I think what the idea was is that you set him up as this, you know, dark shadow of a person. And it's like, oh, this is a bad guy, and then you reveal what he looks like and who he mm-hmm. is, and then it's like, before you even know what he looks like, you just kind of have this idea of, like, this is a bad person.
Yeah,
and it's
you have the, like, impression of who he is without seeing his face.
Yeah, which I think is an interesting way of doing it. Like, you don't, you know, you have the Joker, and you don't show the Joker right away, but you show, like, here's the things he's done, or him from behind killing someone, or, you know, all these different aspects. And then he steps out, and you're like, now you're introduced to this bad guy and stuff. And it's just interesting to have it. And it was just, like, so much shadow on his face for so long. And I was like, huh, okay, interesting.
Yeah, it was really good.
Mm-hmm. There's so much tenseness throughout so many aspects. Like, I think all the Bill stuff, like, all the times he's, like, following people, when he's following Matt Damon, when, like, he's just in situations, I'm like, oh, gosh, please get out of here, please get out of here. Finally caught, you know, whatever, he's finally getting out, and then they, like, it's almost like the tension's kind of starting to let up,
mm-hmm.
and then they just, out of nowhere, and I'm like, fuck.
Yeah. No, it was... I thought he was out, too. So frustrating and so, like, disappointing.
And I don't think we talk about during the discussion at all, but, like, there's this idea of, like, I don't, like I said, without knowing the time span of everything and how long things have been, there is that idea of, like, is the baby Matt's or Leah's, right? Yeah. Like,
it could easily be either of them.
Yeah, if the time span of, like, getting that information with the envelope isn't that far away from all that.
Sure.
A month, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe 2 months. Like, her finding out that she's pregnant and has an ultrasound and stuff, too, that's usually, like, maybe a couple months in, especially to be able to get a penis.
Sure.
So, like, maybe it is, you know, his. Maybe it was Bill's and not Colin's. You know, I don't know.
Yeah.
Now you could end the scene there.
But, yeah, that's just the idea of, like, having a, I don't know, just, like, okay, here's the material I have, and then what can I do more with it?
An actor really imbuing the role, right?
He's trying to be that mafia mobster kind of guy and stuff, too, and... It almost has a little bit of improv to it mm-hmm. in a way, too. Though he's also kind of thinking about it beforehand, too. Yeah. But I just, that's him trying to, like, be that role. His accent wasn't quite as much as the other guys.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes it was there-ish.
Sometimes it was more, sometimes it was less.
There was a couple words where, like, when he would say something, it felt like it was there a lot more. Like, there was, like, those, you know, they have cop and ka and... Like, they had these bigger vowels on a few words. There was a scene somewhere where he did something. Like, maybe he said ka, something like that. I don't know what it was. But, like, he said it, like, in a sentence, and he said it again in the next sentence.
And it didn't sound the same?
Yeah.
I think he said, like...
I think cop was one, maybe, where he said cop. And then the next time he said cop, he just said cop.
It was the interrogation scene where he's smashing the hand. He's like, tell me you're not a cop! Now, swear to me you're not a cop!
Swear to me you're not a cop!
This is not
Shut up. Fucking TikTok, man. It's not even installed.
It's not even installed. It's still taking off my phone.
It's insidious.
So, but the psychologist or...
Madeline.
Yeah, like...
Her name was Madeline Madden.
Was it really?
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Okay.
I'm pretty sure it was Madeline Madden on the card thingy.
But her, But there were some moments with her where, like, it wasn't quite as prominent, and then she'd say some of those words that, like, it just pops out a lot more. I don't know if I want to say a fun movie... Tense movie.
It was,
you know, interesting,
captivating.
Yeah,
it didn't like feel, a lot of Scorsese movies. I'm not satisfied having watched it, but it was an experience.
Sure, and I didn't feel like it was like, it's like 2.5 hours, right? Like 2:25.
Yeah, I didn't feel bored.
No, I didn't. Most of the time, I felt like, shit, just get out of this place. This is terrible.
It was quite tense. The tone was very good.
I guess that's why it's called... That makes more sense. I didn't think about that. They were seen before. I'm like, this is the thing. Yeah. This is the thing. But
yeah, they did that, like, push-in shot.
Yeah,
like,
to the
was
departed.
There anything else about The Departed?
Yeah. And by the end of it, like, that's
everybody.
Guys, thank you so much for watching The Departed with us. We hope you enjoyed this. Don't forget, we have a new movie here every Friday, and you can also see the next 4 weeks of movies over at blindwave.com, as well as full length. All that is linked down below. Poll every other week for what movie to watch. Thank you guys for voting on this one. What's gonna be next time?